Hello, hello, and welcome back to Hitman 2 and the Another Life mission set in Whittleton Creek, Vermont. And today we will be taking care of the Death From Below challenge, which entails killing Janus with an exploding mole hole. So there's a little bit to do in this one, so it will take a little while. So for this one, as usual, we will be bringing with us our ever trusty lockpick, our silence pistol, and some enigmatic poison to take care of Nolan Cassidy. And upon achieving this challenge, we will also get the Tunnel Ducks Rule discovery or feat for discovering the secret passage to Janus's basement. So, right from the start, off the bat, what we're going to do is we're going to make our way along the road here past Nolan Cassidy's house, which is just on our left. And just past that, we will find ourselves the exterminator van, illegally parked, I might add. And behind the exterminator van, we will find the exterminator. So we're going to duck down in the bushes, get behind him, render him unconscious. We're going to grab the two keys that he drops. One is for Cassidy's house and one is for Batty's house, which is the house we're outside now. We're going to drag his body into the bushes. A little bit better than that, that's better. And we're going to take his outfit. So from here, we're going to make our way into Mr. Batty's garden via the garden gate here with the keys we've collected. And we're going to run our way right round to Mr. Batty's shed. And into his shed we will find our first of three clues and a shovel, which will enable us to get our second clue. So just behind the door we're going to grab the shovel, and just on the dresser here we will find our first clue, which is some legal documents. So from there we're going to make our way over to the frog habitat. And just past the bird houses, we will find a prompt on the floor to dig a hole. And in this hole, we will find our second clue, which is a cigar box. So with our first two clues collected, we're now going to move on and take out Nolan Cassidy. So I'm just checking. I know that there's a guard who patrols this area. And we want him to be right over to the left where he will stop. We can then vault over the fence, sneak up behind him, be aware of the camera there. We're going to render him unconscious and quickly take out the camera before it returns on its sweep, because it may spot him. And finding an unconscious man on the floor will alert the other guards. So once the camera has been taken out, we can drag his body into the bush provided. Go back and grab his gun there, we don't want to leave that lying around. And from here, what we're going to do now is approach the fumigation machine and add our enigmatic poison to it. And we're just going to wait here by the controls for Nolan Cassidy and his bodyguard to fully enter the house. They are currently in the garage, but the garage isn't covered by the fumigation machine, so we want them both deep into the kitchen, which they are now. So we're going to activate the fumigation machine. And that is going to make absolutely everybody in the house sick. Now you can see here I'm sort of trying to run, but my controller's playing up, and if I push forwards and run, the run doesn't engage. I have to run at a slight angle now. So with everybody now getting sick, all the bodyguards will leave via the back door here, and Nolan Cassidy will make his way into the bathroom. Way into the house, into the bathroom, and we're going to use instinct here just to make sure that all of the guards get to minimum safe distance, because if we attack Nolan Cassidy too early, one of them will think that the toilet is now free and vacant and will make their way here. So we want to give them plenty of time to escape before we kill Cassidy by drowning him in his own vomit.
Nolan Cassidy is down. Good work, 47. Janus awaits your attention.
So we're going to make our way from Cassidy's dead body to the kitchen and take out the surveillance system just to erase the camera that has seen us. And from here we're going to exit via the window back out onto the main street, and we're going to retrieve our suit. We don't want to be running around in dirty overalls all day. So once we've got our suit back on, we're going to make our way around the map, past the creek where the house for sale is, and we want to make our way to the house opposite this one, which is actually vacant. There is one person, I believe a plumber, trying to fix the kitchen sink in there. But we're going to make our way around to the front of the house. And it's the house with the boat outside the front. So whoever does live here has a bit of money. And once we get round to the front of the house, we want to lockpick our way through the garage door, being aware that the mailman is in this area at this time, that he hasn't spotted us. So we're going to make our way into the garage, lockpick our way through the door at the back of the room, and down into the basement. And through the basement we come to two doors. One leads to the garden and one leads to a secret little book room. And on the bookshelf here, just like James Bond, we're going to trigger the secret door, and that will get us the Tunnel Ducks Rule Challenge. It won't pop for me because I accidentally got it during a practice run. And at the far end of the tunnel, it brings us out into Janus's basement. So what we're going to do is unlock the secret door, make our way to the foot of the stairs, and just wait for the guard in this area to have his back to us. And then we can sneak our way over to the filing cabinets, and we're just going to wait for him to move off again. He's going to go and stand by the foot of the stairs. And when he does, we're going to grab our third clue, which is this photograph right here. And we're going to plug ourselves up just against the wall here, and we're going to once again wait for the bodyguard to move off before we make our way back through the secret tunnel and back out onto the main street. So he's going to wander off now. We're going to make our way back into the tunnel. There are a number of items in here, including a couple of disguises. One of them is Janus's bodyguard's disguise, I believe. So through the tunnel, back through the basement, and back up the stairs out onto the main road, where we will hang a quick right. And what we need to do now basically is acquire ourselves a gardener's outfit, but we also need to trigger a conversation. Now usually we go the other way and automatically trigger this conversation as we run straight past, but we need to get this gardener and this cop talking. And basically the cop has taken away the gardener's explosives for dealing with the mole problem. And what we're going to do is just wait across the road here until that conversation has played out. It takes a few minutes, and eventually the cop will wander off with the explosives and put them somewhere safe. And the gardener will make his way over to his vehicle, which is the one right in front of us here. And when he gets here, we can then sneak up behind him and render him unconscious and hide his body in the bushes. So once he's in position, he will stand with his back to us. We can just crouch down, render him unconscious. We need to do this quickly before any of the joggers in the area come by. And we're just going to drag his body nice and deep into these bushes here. We're going to take his outfit, because his is the outfit that we need. And back to where we knocked him out, we will find a key to Janus's house, and that will just come in quite handy, saving a lockpick our way in. And then from here we're going to make our way along the road to the very edge of the road, where we find a small sort of sealed off section. And we're going to sneak our way past the barricade here and into the bushes. This is where the explosive is being stored. We just need to wait for this construction worker to have his back to us. He's playing with his clipboard at the moment, but he will eventually turn round and wander off. And we can sneak out of the bushes, grab the explosives, sneak back in the bushes, hide the explosives, and make our way out of the area. So we now have almost everything we need. We do still need a few more items, but we're going to make our way over to Janus's house, and we're going to make our way into the garden. And we want to go in via the side of the house near the garage. On the other side there are a couple of enforcers wandering around. This side's pretty clear. So we're going to make our way into the Janus's garden, and we're going to run straight to the edge of the back of the garden, and we're going to vault over the fence into the Wilson's garden party, where we will retrieve our last 5 items. And basically what we need is 5 items to plug up all of the mole holes. And there are a lot of items dotted around in this area. I'm going for all of the soda cans, and we need 5 items in total. So I've just gone around and grabbed 5 soda cans. There are a couple of items elsewhere in the map you can use. You can pretty much stuff anything you want into these mole holes. But once we have 5 items, we're going to vault our way back into Janus's garden. And we're looking for one of the bodyguards. He's wearing a yellow top, and here he comes now.
I understand you have a mole problem.
Oh, you're a godsend. Let's get straight to it. The sooner this is fixed, the sooner I won't have to listen to Mr. Janus's complaints. Follow me.
So we're just going to approach this guy and initiate a conversation with him. And he is going to lead us over to the vegetable patch in the far corner of the garden here. We've just managed to beat him here, and he will continue
Master
our conversation.
Meat Twister, as you can see, we have a mole issue. Now, I know a permanent solution might take some time, but if you could just fill the holes by the end of the day, it'd be great. Come find me when you're done.
So once he's given us our instructions, what we're going to do is go around and we're going to fill the 6 mole holes, starting with that one. And the one at the vegetable patch right here is the one we're going to plant our explosive device in. And from there, we're just going to carry on moving around and plant our soda cans in all of the rest of the mole holes. There's a pretty straightforward path to just follow them all. Plug in each hole with a can as we go, and once we've done this, hopefully our timing is right and we will re-bump into the guy in the yellow top right there. He will still be here having his conversation, so we don't have to go near the other side of the garden where the enforcers are.
Maybe you should try to spark some of those old stories for yourself. Who knows what secrets Janus might reveal.
So once we tell the guard that we've plugged all of the holes, he's going to go and have a quick look for himself, and then he's going to call Janus.
Let me get Mr. Janus so we can inspect it for himself.
Nothing new for you today.
Hey, tell Mr. Janus the molehills have been fixed.
So once he is called for Mr. Janus, what we are going to do is vault back over the fence into the Wilson's garden party, and we're just going to wait roughly about here somewhere and await the arrival of Janus. He is a very old man and he moves very slowly, so this can take a couple of minutes. He is going to go and speak to his head of security there, or head of the garden security. And he will eventually go over to the vegetable patch and investigate the mole holes. Now, if you time this right, you can just kill Janus and not his personal bodyguard, who does follow him quite closely. But you will lose your silent assassin rating at this point.
At last, the actions of the first constant catch up with you. Death feels like an easy way out for a man like Janus.
So as you see, my controller hiccup is almost getting me caught there. Not that it matters, because we will lose the silent assassin rating, like I said. But there you go, that is the Death From Below challenge taken care of. I have been Anubis, and I will see you all in the next video.